Hello everybody. What we're going to be doing today is pouring molten aluminum into snow. Okay, so this aluminum's had a couple of minutes to cool down. I'm just gonna pick the stuff off the top with my hands. I've got gloves on, of course. And the big main section I'm going to be using pliers to pull out because I imagine it's still pretty hot. But let's get to it. Come on, focus. As you can see, it produces some really weird crystalline patterns right here. And there's still some wavy sections. I'll try to get this in some better light after I'm done pulling the aluminum out to get a better look at it. You can kind of see here, produces some very weird patterns. Here you can see, kind of split off onto multiple little, I guess, funnel shapes. And there's a little piece of grass on it. But yeah, that's what I'm talking about there, is there's some weird, it's almost kind of like, almost looks like it's a snowflake inside it. But yeah, I'll get these cleaned up and I'll put them under some good light. And we'll have a look at them. Well everyone, as you can see, when you pour molten aluminum into snow, it produces some very weird results. And that's one of the things that I like about it, is that unlike pouring it into pumpkin or any type of defined object, it ends up being roughly the same shape each time. And the thing about pouring molten aluminum into snow is that each individual pile of snow has a unique structure to it. The aluminum just follows whatever path is of the least resistance. Like I said, some of the aluminum has like a grainy texture to it, and some of the other aluminum is spots where it's bubbled up and produced a cavity inside a large bulb, more than likely due to the steam being released as the snow melts into water, and then that water boils into vapor. So it's definitely an interesting result. Well everyone, that's pretty much it for today. If you like the video, click that like button. If you enjoyed it, consider sharing it with a friend. Perhaps they'd like to watch it as well. If you haven't already, please consider subscribing to my channel. I do videos every week, and most of my videos are just weird, random science experiments. Things that hopefully nobody else has tried before. The whole point is just kind of scientific discovery. But yeah, like I said, that's pretty much it for today. Thanks for watching.